I am here with Adora Svitak, who is the youngest speaker here today at TED. And could you just tell us a little bit about what your interests are and what you do and what brought you to TED?
Sure. Well, I've been teaching and speaking for a long time. Ever since I published my first book, Flying Fingers, I've been going around the world talking to other students about reading and writing. That really grew into talking to teachers, talking to adults and parents about education. And I wanted to make a larger difference as well, so I called TED up. I had heard about their conference. I've been watching TED Talks for a long time, and I said, you know what, I would really like to be a part of this. And they booked me at the last minute, kind of, and that's how I came here. It's really a great story, I think, of how I managed to squeeze in. And I've just been really thrilled to be here and see all the great speakers.
So what do you like best about teaching other kids? Is there anything that stands out that you really enjoy with working with other kids?
Power. No, you wouldn't believe how fulfilling it can be to have that knowledge that you are making a difference in the lives of other kids, and knowing that you are helping change somebody's view. Reading is boring, reading isn't fun, to wow, maybe it's actually kind of cool, I should check it out. And I think it's important for kids to have role models. I know that a lot of kids have adult authors to look up to, but there haven't been that many other kid authors to look up to, so yeah, that's really important.
In your talk, you talked a bit about how adults should pay more attention and should start learning from kids. Can you tell us a little bit more about that idea?
Sure. Well, I think it's really important for adults to learn from kids because we have a really different perspective of the world. We have a kid's eye view that can be intensely valuable, I think, when it comes to changing the world, when it comes to new ideas, because adults are in many ways confined by society's restrictions, and kids can be not as hampered in that aspect. So I think it's really important to get that unique view.
So you've been working with computers for a long time already now. Is there anything about computers or technology that particularly interests you or excites you that's going on now?
Well, I love new technology, and I was so thrilled that everybody got a free phone at TED. That was like a really high point of my, well, no, actually listening to speakers is a really high point, to be a little more correct, but getting the free phone, that was amazing. And I've never seen a Google phone before. I've heard of it, so that was really amazing. And definitely seeing the newest in tablet technology from Apple, although TED did show a funny little spoof commercial for the iPad, and it was a little notepad, $499, so I thought that was really funny. But definitely, as new technology comes out, I'm always looking at it, not just for the sake of using it and gaming and it being cool, but also for how can we apply this in a broader sense to things like education or to making a difference or to helping others.
So you're on Twitter, and I wanted to let our readers know that they can follow you at, what's your Twitter address?
Twitter.com/Adora, A-D-O-R-A-S-V, and for every new follower, I'm actually donating one penny to Save the Children's Haiti Relief Effort.
That's awesome, great. And what do you like about Twitter? Do you have any favorite parts or favorite thoughts about Twitter?
It kind of forces me to be more concise. A lot of times, I like to use big words and lots of rathers, or in other words, and Twitter really forces you to think, oh, you know what, if that's going to put me under the 140 letters limit, I better cut that. And it's a good lesson, not just for microblogging, but also for when I speak. Like 6 minutes here at TED, I usually speak 60 minutes, and the knowing how to shorten, knowing how to become more concise really helped me.
All right, great. Thanks so much
Thank
for
you.
Talking to us.